As we dug into the controller's specs and our motor's SepEx field, we became concerned about whether the components we bought would play nice together. Having hit a bit of a wall, we called our friend in Georgia to see if he could help.
Can we get our motor and controller to do regenerative braking? Or if not, is there a minimum viable product where it will work, it just won't do regen?
We kind of envisioned that the SepEx would be for regen only. We'd put power in through the other terminals. But it seems like our controller doesn't have a separate input for regen.
Yes, you can use that SepEx field for regen braking. What you don't know initially is which way to connect that SepEx field. You connect it as positive negative this way or as positive negative this way. That SepEx field, first of all, it needs to be connected to a completely different supply. Start off with that field at 12 volts. You energize the SepEx field first. You turn the potentiometer up and see what the armature does. The more you energize that SepEx field, the more current you put through it, the lower the RPM is, the lower the RPM the motor's going to run at, more torque it's gonna have.
We didn't have any normal spare wire, but we did have coaxial cables, so Jason's just been fashioning these makeshift testing wires.
I also didn't bring wire strippers.
Very professional.
Coaxial cables just couldn't take the heat.
In fact, they generated quite a bit of heat. We're gonna get a pair of jumper cables to test this part of the motor, and then just hope that those crappy cables we just engineered will be able to test the SepEx field. We have upgraded this side. We've confirmed that it works.
First, hook up the SepEx field. When you hook up the SepEx field, nothing's gonna happen. You'll see a little spark and you'll see a small spark where you see this current flowing. Hook up the brushes to a 12 volt battery. See which way it turns. Disconnect the SepEx field.
Positive in this hand, negative in this hand.
Then just connect the brushes hooked up with the series field and then see which way it turns. If they're turning the opposite direction of one another, then you'll have to flip the SepEx field so they're both turning in the same direction.
Let's try it. Yeah, try it the other way.
Uh-huh. It was much slower until
he
took those off.
Oh, okay.
So probably the correct way. We want to put negative in F2 and positive in F1.
You really need another little separate controller for that SepEx field.
And this is our SepEx controller. I don't know what this is. Plastic.
The hair of somebody who manufactured it.
So these are the terminals here. Motor minus, motor plus, power minus. Then these are MOSFETs.
How would you recommend we load our motor for testing?
You just can't let it spin up fast. I don't ever load mine. You gotta have some savvy and don't let it spin up that fast.
Just wiring everything back up for another test, this time in half throttle mode.
We didn't have time to show this in the video about programming the controller, but there was a spark at one point and we thought we ruined the controller. The spark was probably caused by inrush current.
Oh, what's wrong?
Something sparked here.
Uh-oh.
On the controller?
Yeah.
That's not good.
The way we were doing pre-charge at the time was essentially manual and prone to human error. We've since addressed that issue. So post-spark, the controller has still worked for 10-second intervals.
Let's see.
Uh-oh.
It was an open question whether it was the controller or a battery that fails after 10 seconds. Remember, battery 18's voltage had dropped quite low.
Wiring this up as our SepEx controller. Screw blocks here, though, which will require much thinner wire than we're using right now. Die hard or go home. We wired the SepEx terminals up to the controller, and now we're just doing the last power wire on the controller. I'm going to have to somehow do this without bridging anything. If we don't short anything, we're going to have the Solana Garden battery hooked up to this controller, and we should be able to vary the amount of current we apply to the SepEx field. Is it current or is it something else?
I think it's
voltage.
Your juice.
Right. I got my little control knob here. Jason's gonna play with the pedal. Okay, that works. Are you not moving it at all?
I wasn't changing how much I had this pressed, so.
Okay, so if I take this all the way to the right, it accelerates. It slows down the further left I go. Assuming you're holding speed constant. Now, yep, now it's all the way to the right. SepEx controller's on, hold it steady. So, I have SepEx all the way up now. Something's happening.
Torque. Oh, well, I think we lost it again.
Okay, I'm turning the SepEx up again. Mm-hmm. No, it just died again. So storage, we've disconnected battery 18 since it's starting to read much lower than all the rest. I'm gonna see if it continues to drain itself without being attached to anything else.
When you put in the car, you don't want the SepEx field to always be energized. You want a switch like a relay going to the SepEx field so that when you press the accelerator, there's a switch that closes the contact of your solenoid to energize the SepEx field. Because you don't want it to sit there and just burn power and get hot. When you're doing your regen braking, somehow you bypass your series field activate your SepEx field, and then your controller will reach in off of the armature brushes. Does that make sense?
We need to have like a big contactor solid, probably going to do something like that.
Solenoid that will bypass the series field, completely disconnected, but connected to both sides of the brushes, going to your controller, and you energize your SepEx field. You basically now have a generator.
When we're accelerating, we have the armature and the series connected. Right. They're bridged. And then whenever we take the gas off or whatever we need to regen, we have to break that connection between the armature and the series.
Around this point, we took a break from the SepEx to work on the charger, which we covered in our previous video.
After about a month's hiatus, we are here again to try to test the SepEx with the motor and see if we still get that automatically shutting off problem.
We have giant heat shrink that we're going to put on these wires. Looks a little excessive, but it says that it'll shrink to the right size. Some things shrink when they're colder, others shrink when they're warmer.
All right, this looks a lot better with the heat shrink on it. Kind of like the nuclear launch sequence. So we've got SepEx. Okay. Power supply is on.
Pre-charge.
Yep. There we go. Switch on the main. Pre-charge off. So that's working. Now what happens if we adjust the SepEx? SepEx control is on. Turning it up slowly. Still working. Okay, I'm turning it up more. Okay, so it's not doing the shutoff thing. Okay, now it's all the way on. So if you just keep it exactly where you have it. Yep.
Yeah, okay.
I'll turn it back the other way again. Now it's just a question of getting it to trigger with the pedal the way that Raleigh said. So assume what happens is, like, at the lower RPM we get more torque, right? This leads to a lot of questions, like, why was it shutting off automatically before?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, check the BMS, see what's going on. What happens if I turn on the SepEx with no throttle?
Oh, there's nothing.
Nothing is correct. We're at 99.8, so about 18. 18 was the one that was supposed to be our problem.
That seems okay.
And it's been off for a while. It will drain if you run it.
Yeah, we're gonna see. Yeah, we're getting negative amps now. 10 amps. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure if it actually had load on it, we could make that number higher.
Oh, yeah.
We think the reason it works now and failed earlier is because, before we got our charger, battery 18 was right at the edge of the voltage where a lithium iron phosphate battery will discharge properly. When we were running our tests before we charged the whole system, we were running just on the voltage that the batteries shipped with from the factory. After charging the batteries and changing nothing else, the system works, suggesting that the problem was the low charge, which has now been fixed. We don't have regen working yet, but we have our minimum viable product. Regen braking will be a project for another day.
If you're in your gasoline car and you open the throttle wide up, it'll just keep running until it explodes.
We're trying to avoid explosions, just as a general rule.
That SepEx field keeps that from happening. That's one of the reasons why it was there.
Okay.
You energize that SepEx field, it is not going to run away. You want to pull up a hill and you crank the current up all the way on your SepEx field, and you mash that accelerator, it's going to jump. And you're starting to cruise, you back off that SepEx field, you start going faster.
We should have a burnout mode.
Yeah.
To be honest, I would be surprised if everything we got works together the first time we assemble it. We may need to buy things. That wouldn't shock me, but
it might.
And as always, if you want to help buy parts, check out the links in the description.
If both of these things were true, that we were all very short and we constantly cause short circuits, like if we were worse at this than we are, then yeah. A great name for our channel would be Short Kings.
I'm ordering food. Add extra fries, select as many as I'd like. Okay, I've selected how many extra fries I'd like, and that is the number yes.